It's AumSum time!
Why do we blink?
To look adorable and innocent.
No. An average person blinks about 10 to 20 times per minute. Blinking helps spread water, oil, mucus, etc. across our eyes and wipe out dust. However, this is not the only purpose of blinking. Experts notice that the exact moments when we blink are not random. While reading, we tend to blink at the end of sentences. While listening, we blink when speaker takes pauses. Hence, using fMRI scanners, experts observe the brains of some individuals. The analysis showed that while blinking, mental activity dipped in areas which control attention, while the activity spiked in areas called default mode network. This network operates when mind is in a state of wakeful rest. Based on these observations, experts hypothesize that blinking acts as a tiny mental break, thus allowing us to pay more attention when we open our eyes again. What is the Big Bang Theory? Many of us wonder how everything, that is humans, trees, planets, stars, galaxies, and even space and time came into existence. How did our universe originate? Now, there are several theories, beliefs, and myths about the beginning of our universe. However, the most widely accepted explanation is the Big Bang Theory, which scientists use to describe the initial formation of our universe. It states that our universe began from a very hot and compressed point, which is also known as a singularity. Based on estimations, it is said that approximately 13.7 or 13.8 billion years ago, the singularity violently exploded. This explosion is called the Big Bang. Scientists claim that from this explosion or Big Bang, space, time, energy, matter, and then stars, galaxies, humans, etc. came into existence. Now, you must be wondering, what happened before the Big Bang at singularity? It is said that at singularity, laws of physics and time did not exist. If time did not exist, then there is no reference point to determine what happened before the Big Bang. What is a hangover? Usually, when we drink too much alcohol, we experience an extreme headache, nausea, vomiting, etc. the next morning. This condition is called a hangover. Now, we get a hangover because alcohol is a diuretic. This means it makes you urinate a lot, making us lose more water and thus causing our body to get dehydrated. When our body gets dehydrated, it begins to steal water from the brain, causing it to shrink and thus giving us a hangover headache. In addition to this, when we drink alcohol, our liver breaks down the alcohol into toxic acetaldehyde and then into harmless acetate. However, when we drink too much, we cannot convert toxic acetaldehyde as quickly as usual. Hence, it begins to build up in our body and thus causing hangover nausea and vomiting. Moreover, different types of alcohol have different amounts of congeners, which are basically impurities. If we drink the alcohol which has more congeners, then it can increase the severity of a hangover. How do animals hibernate? Usually during winter. It is quite cold and the food is scarce. Hence, in order to survive during winter, many animals snuggle up in burrows, caves, tree trunks, etc. and remain inactive as if they are in a deep sleep. The state of inactivity is called hibernation, and the animals which hibernate, such as bears, bats, groundhogs, ground squirrels, etc. are called hibernators. Now, during hibernation, many changes take place in their bodies. For example, their heartbeat and breathing rate slow down. Their body temperature goes way down. Also, many animals don't even eat or drink. Instead, they eat a lot before hibernating and store the food in their bodies in the form of fat. Then, while hibernating, the hibernators use the stored fat to keep themselves alive in the winter. Depending on the species, some of them might not even urinate or defecate for days or weeks. Then, when winter is over and the climate is favorable, the hibernators wake up and perform their regular activities.